Welcome, everybody. My name is Mark Cosgrove, and I'm the head of programme at Watershed. And delighted to talk to Dave tonight, founder of Aardman, and now chief executive of Aardman. So we didn't have this building. It all started in a kitchen and a table.
It all started in a kitchen table, yeah. Pete and I met as school kids. We were in Surrey. Interesting little story in that the class was arranged alphabetically in this grammar school. And this kid came in about 6 weeks into one term with a very strong accent and Australian accent. And the only spare seat was next to me. We had big class sizes and they said, you better go and sit next to Sproxton. And I said, well, who are you? He said, my name's Peter Lord. I got the Peter bit. The Lord bit took me about 3 weeks to get. And so he just started writing and drawing. And that's kind of interesting. And we met in that circumstance in grammar school in the second year. Funny enough, both our mothers taught art. My mother had an art degree. Both our fathers were in the BBC. His father's in the sales side. My father was a documentary producer and a kind of theologian working for the religious programs department in the BBC. Pete and I got to be great mates, and we started playing and thinking up stories. And I was always interested in photography and kind of, I guess, like process, the whole thing about films. I remember seeing one of my formative films was actually Lawrence of Arabia, and thinking, God, how do you photograph that? What's all that about? And I guess I thought making films is all about the photography side of it. And I was intrigued kind of with the process. Anyway, to cut a long story short, one day we got out the Bolex, stuck it up on a little stand, and actually just cut up images out of colour supplements and stuff. We'd obviously watched programmes like Vision On, which used a plethora of styles, and cutout's the easiest thing to do. We didn't really understand cell animation or actually how you drew stuff. It's actually push stuff around, and we did stuff with chalk drawings. But I actually have here the very first piece we actually did. The interesting thing about this is it's completely unstructured. And as you can see, it's just paper cutouts, pretty abstract, silly stuff, very flashy because it's shot on a sprung round Bolex. And this is the very first piece that we shot. And of course, you know, in those days, 16mm, it went off the lab, a little bit of Charlie Parker on top. Completely random, really, formless. But we got it back and we laughed our socks off. We thought, this is great, this is really silly. And of course, it had political undertones. The Heath era, and those credits pretty well said all. And that thing was kind of enough to kind of say to us, this is good fun, this is a laugh, because it's very exciting. You couldn't see what you were doing at all in those days. 16mm off to the lab, a number of days later, watching on a little hand wire thing. We did have a projector. And we were delighted by it. We thought it was great. Hey, this is good fun. And it got shown to the producer of Vision On. He went to see Dad and they got chatting and Dad obviously said, actually, my boy is doing some animation. Could you take a look at it? Do you want to have a look at it? And Patrick Dowling said, sure, fine, take a look. You know, any talent that's going for cheap, I'll use it. And he saw, I think we showed him that. And he said, look, here's a 100-foot of film. Here are the themes for the next series of Vision On. Just fill it up with what you like. And we didn't know what to do. We had these themes and we did this little next piece I'm going to show you. And we did a little bit of cell animation. But this is the sort of fun that we used to have. And this is why we didn't have any friends, because this is a classic piece of what they call pixelation. You get your mates dressed up and you tell them to jump up in the air, and every time they're up in the air, you take a frame, and the result is this. We were just experimenting, and again, it was formless, it was fun. You'd seen, I suppose, again, probably Python, some of the trick films that were on TV. Right. It's what you could do with film, running backwards, stop frame, upside down, all that kind of stuff. We got a kind of break, really, with this producer. The show was actually recorded in Bristol here. And that's actually why we were in Bristol, to be honest. We kind of followed, as we followed the money. Pete was actually born in Bristol. My girlfriend was in Bristol. And Vision On was recorded here.
Was that in the BBC, White Ladies
BBC
Road?
BBC, White Ladies Road, okay. Yeah. And we'd, so we'd come, left home, came out of, left Surrey, came down to Bristol.
So you're very much working on, I mean, you and Pete working on your own in Bristol, yeah. Doing this work for...
Yeah, yeah. In a initially a little house. But as part of that 100-foot reel which we were given, animation's kind of 2D, it's classical drawn stuff. And we'd come up with this character who was a complete idiot of a character called Aardman. We'd been playing with words actually at school. The word aardvark, we couldn't find another word with more A's in it than aardvark, this sort of Dutch word. And we thought, this is a hilarious word. What about an Aardman? We should have probably put MAAN, actually. And we did this little sequence on that reel. And original producer thought this is great. It's the oldest gag in the book almost. And the BBC actually bought it. This is actually the very first sequence which went on air for the grand sum of about £25. And we got a check. And we thought, well, we need to open an account for this thing. And what should we call this bank account? Sproxton Law, Dave Pete.
Yeah.
And we thought, well, let's call it Aardman. And Aardman Films, Aardman, mm. Aardman. Mm. And Aardman Animations, let's call it that, yeah. As a laugh. Yeah. You could register your name, and nobody could indicate. It wasn't limited, it was just the registration. Yeah. Got a nice little formal piece of paper, put it on in a frame. Oh, yeah. There we are. Aardman Animations. Exactly. Completely a schoolboy prank, thinking, you know, that's a stupid thing to do.
Yeah.
And based on this rather idiotic character.